The intermolecular attraction between water molecules is better known as cohesion. Examples of cohesion can be observed all around us. If we just take a moment and have a closer look. Notice how the droplets look to merge, as if they've been pulled towards each other. Or how the droplet then seems to stretch as it falls off the leaf. Now let's have another look at a droplet hitting the water surface, paying close attention to how the surface behaves. The surface seems to bend and distort rather than breaking, as if there was a thin film protecting the water. This seemingly elastic behavior of water can be explained by a fascinating phenomenon called surface tension. Now let's take a closer look at the surface molecules. In its liquid state, the water molecules are constantly moving and forming hydrogen bonds with their neighboring molecules all around them. But the molecules at the surface, however, have no other molecules above them to form hydrogen bonds with. This results in an imbalance of forces. The surface molecules are pulled more strongly by their neighbors beneath and next to them. This creates tension at the water's surface, a type of invisible and elastic skin. This surface tension is strong enough to allow some insects to walk on water. The water strider, with its long, spindly legs, has evolved to exploit this phenomenon to perfection. Each foot presses down just enough to dimple the water, but not to break the surface. A delicate balance between gravity and molecular cohesion. The cohesive forces at water's surface also gives rise to another natural wonder: water's tendency to form in spherical shapes. The spherical shape of water is best observed in small droplets, where the surface tension is more dominant than the gravitational forces. But as the volume of water becomes larger, it becomes heavier, and gravity starts to play a much more significant role in determining its shape. This fascinating balance of forces at play can also be seen when the water's surface is disturbed. Small ripples caused by a raindrop or a gentle wind are also known as capillary waves. The capillary waves are small enough that their dynamics are dominated by the surface tension, as it quickly smoothens out the ripples. Whereas when the waves become larger, the effects of gravity and inertia become more significant. This explains why water behaves differently across scales, but follows the same physical principles of force balance. But what would happen to this balance if we were to remove gravity from the equation? In environments with little to no gravity, such as space, even larger bodies of water would form into spherical shapes due to the cohesive force between the surface molecules. The reason water seeks to form this shape is because the sphere provides the smallest surface area for any given volume. By reducing its surface area to the smallest possible size, a droplet achieves an energetically efficient and stable form, demonstrating the elegant simplicity of physical laws at work. This is one of the cornerstone principles in physics when studying the behavior of the natural world, better known as the principle of minimum energy. Water molecules are not only attracted to each other, but also make bonds with different types of molecules. In our next chapter, we will discover water molecules' ability to stick to other molecules and witness its remarkable ability to defy gravity itself, ascending even the tallest of trees on our planet.